Okay, my little video on this loading press here. Get it all in frame here, sort of, kind of. So, anyway, this is a CH, and I'm not really sure on the model, but I think it's like 333 or something or other. Because it's a three-stage press, you can see there. Because they did make ones that were pretty much the same kind of design, but they just, some had just a single stage in the middle, or... I don't know if there was a two-stage one, I guess, or two-station. And there was, like, one with four stations that had, like, a part in the middle here. So, but there's a little bit of information online. Most stuff you look up on them, there's just ones for sale on Arms List or something like that. But, so anyway, I've had this quite a long time. I picked it up. I bought a whole bunch of stuff off an older gentleman. He was getting on a reload or whatever. And I gave him like $75, and I bought like this, and it was all kinds of different stuff with it. But it's, I think it's all, I don't know if this thing is like 1960s or what really the time period is, because the like loading manuals he had were from like 1964. I think it was the newest one, so looks kind of that old, but I'm not really that sure. And I looked into it a bit, but you know. So if I first got the thing, I thought, yeah, it'd be kind of cool because it's three stations, and so I put it on a board and everything, and I thought I was going to use the thing, but then I kind of discovered it has a few shortcomings, as I don't have all like enough parts for it to really use it as like a three-stage, and it's not really universal with like newer shell holders for some weird reason. I don't know why it's that way, but I'll try to show you that. You have like your... This, I guess, be like your full-length size station. Then there's a priming station here. You can see the priming stem, or we want to call it, right there. And it has these kind of universal, like the things that hold the shell holders. They're kind of like this one, but this one's actually designated for 222 Remington. There's a nut on the bottom you take off, and then you put it in the station and put the nut on. These ones here are ones that'll hold like normal shell holders, but I only have two of them, so that means so yeah, that's kind of a problem. And it also came with it appears to be like special, sort of semi-special shell holders for the thing. They look pretty much similar to any other shell holder, but there's a little bit difference about them. Like, see, when you prime this by, you know, pushing the handle forward, so you put your shell holder in, and I only have two of these. Like, there's a number one and the number, no, wait a second, I got three of them. No, I got two number ones and one number eight, so I think number one is probably like 308, 306 kind of deal, and I don't know what this one is, but anyway. So you put your shell holder in, then you can push your thing, and the priming thing will come up, you can see. It comes up through. So it's like, that's fine and dandy. But then if you go to, like, sort of a normal or newer shell holder, this is an RCBS number 3. You put that in, and then it won't... Let's try to do this so you can see. It won't let the priming thing come up far enough. It sort of almost works, but it's not quite. It won't seat the primer like below flush kind of deal. So, and the reason for that I sort of noticed with, if you look at the, you can see this, but the back side of a, or underside of a shell holder, it's sort of, you know, it's tapered a little bit, and then it's a little bit smaller. This one doesn't really have that taper. It's just got, it sort of goes in. It's sort of square up in there. It's kind of hard to see because it's blued, but it's has a bigger hole that lets this like a little shroud on the little cup there that holds your primer, or supposed to. This one doesn't really work that well. It lets that go up in there. You can see it kind of goes up inside of the shell holder, where this one, it sits on it. So I don't know why they're like that. kind of weird, but maybe this is from a time period where shell holders weren't like universal for everybody, or they want you to buy their shell holders, I guess. But so that's probably from quite a few years ago. Because there was like there were some other presses. I don't know, was it Bonanza or something that was called. And it had like a weird universal shell holder. Didn't use shell holders. It had like a little plates or something that came together. I think that company's defunct too. But like CH, they've been I guess bought out, and they're part of like what CH4D or something. I think they still make stuff, but they're just part of something else now. So, I don't know, I suppose if I could buy parts on eBay or something or other, because it's a well put together press, it's cast aluminum or something, but it's heavy steel linkage on it and everything, and big bolts holding it all together, and everything there, looks pretty double things on here, but I don't really technically need the priming station there. I suppose I could prime separately and then just use the three stages for, I don't know, you know, kind of belling and, or flaring and belling and seating and stuff like that. But I don't know. I'd probably be better off buying one of like the, what was it, that Redding with the seven stations on top than have to worry about all this stuff. But anyway, it's one of those kind of things you end up with when you end up buying a bunch of reloading stuff. Sometimes you get stuff that's sort of weird, kind of oddball stuff. So anyway, leave a comment what you think, or if anybody else has one, or whatever.